Welcome to Huon's College Virtual Open Evening. Given the difficult circumstances in which we find ourselves at the start of this most unusual year, at Huon's College we have done our absolute utmost to ensure that every student and every staff member is as safe as they can be. For example, at the entrance to reception and to two other buildings in the college, we have thermal imaging cameras that will pick up anybody whose temperature is over 97.8 degrees and then we can take action. We have hand sanitising stations right across the college and we have social distancing rules at break times, lunch times and within lessons as well. In areas where students share items or equipment, these items or equipment are wiped down with disinfectant between every usage. So, I hope you can see that we are fully safe, fully COVID safe, or as much as we can be, because we take the safety and well-being of everybody in the college very, very seriously.
Welcome to Huon's College. I'm now going to walk you to the office of the principal to meet him.
Hello, my name's Stephen Waldron. I am the principal of Huon's College. I'd like to extend a very warm welcome to families across Hillingdon Borough to the first ever Huon's College virtual open evening. This collection of events and videos and presentations is about giving you a clear picture of life at Huon's College, our philosophies around success and learning, and an understanding of how we aim to achieve our mission of ensuring that every child, regardless of their starting point or their background, can excel. Huon's College is a rapidly improving 11 to 19 academy based on Huon's Road in Hayes. Part of the Rosedale Huon's Academy Trust, the college has an ethos that is built on community, kindness, togetherness and success. This summer, the college achieved its best GCSE and A-level results for many years, with Year 13 students moving on to some of the UK's top universities. With an improving reputation, the college is growing fast and is approaching oversubscription in some year groups. The achievements experienced by the students and staff of Huon's College since our Ofsted inspection in 2019 have been remarkable, and we are extremely proud of the way in which we have striven together to create a vibrant, calm, kind and caring environment where we now have the highest expectations for conduct and attainment. This is a school where no student is left behind, where every child feels valued and contributes, and where we help students achieve more than they thought possible. And if you thought you knew Huon's College, I would suggest that you might like to think again. As a child of the 80s, I was entranced by movies, a love that persisted throughout my life. I was particularly drawn to the films that took you beyond the everyday, that suggested new ideas, new ways of thinking, and offered different perspectives on all of our futures. One of the great Hollywood directors, Steven Spielberg, attributed the allure of his most successful movies to their ability to awaken what he called a sense of wonder in his audiences. For 2 hours, being taken on a journey of discovery that encourages you to dream of possibilities and awaken ideas that you never knew you had. It's this unleashing of this sense of wonder that I believe should be the driving force behind children's learning, to awaken curiosity and an urgency to discover, understand, and change the world around them for the better. This might sound like a lofty ambition, but I believe in the power of vision and the daily influence of environment in creating an atmosphere where this sense of wonder can be absorbed, lived, and learnt every single day. At Huon's, our ultimate aim is for our students to leave us ready to change the world, equipped with the tools that will allow them to be happy, successful, self-reliant and creative members of the society that their generation will build. So, how can we work together to achieve these aims for your children? Firstly, by living every day according to a set of values that run like a thread through every aspect of school life. These values take the form of statements, our mantra for success. We are optimists. We are confident. We contribute to our society. We care for each other. We succeed. But above all else, be kind and work hard. Whether a student is learning geometrical principles, is discovering the wonders of Shakespeare, designing a piece of software, or developing skills to score better shots on the netball court, these mantras will echo through their learning experience. Research in the USA has demonstrated clearly that the act of daily positive affirmation, of truly understanding and believing in a set of values, has an unparalleled influence on a student's attitudes to work and the commitment to success. Therefore, we make no apologies at Huon's College that these ideas will permeate everything that we do. Secondly, we ensure that every child is treated as an individual, not as an anonymous member of a school collective. We are all different. Again, research across the world has demonstrated that all of us learn in different ways, respond better to some stimuli than to others, and have different ways of coping with challenges and difficulties. Our promise to you is that once they join us, we will do our utmost to understand each and every child as an individual and design their learning to suit their needs. There's no room for a one-size-fits-all approach at Huon's College, and we are never complacent enough to be happy with the middle ground. Through our pastoral and tutor system, we will discover exactly what makes every child tick. Our team share information and review approaches constantly to ensure that each student experiences lessons that motivate and engage them in a number of ways. Acting as academic coaches, our teachers and TLAs will develop deep understanding of each of the students in their care and ensure that learning is best designed for their needs. So, using coaching, assessment, and the close tracking of learning development, we can ensure that every child has the best opportunity to make the best progress they can, unleashing the potential that lies within them all. It is said that all of us have talents, it's just that some of us have not found the key to unlock the door to them yet. Our job is to help your child discover those talents, to nurture them, and to provide them with the keys that will unlock the door to their next level of development. And as we all know, growing up through teenage years can be traumatic, with children confronted by new influences, feelings and perspectives at a time when we are demanding the most from them academically. Therefore, at Huon's College, we ensure that our pastoral and special educational needs team have everything they need in order to care for, support and guide our young people through these vital years. Working closely with the most important members of our team, you, the parents, carers and guardians, we can ensure that when a member of our college family hits hard times, that they have the confidence, tools and knowledge that they are cared for to overcome any hurdles placed before them. Ultimately, however, of course, students need results and qualifications to move forward. I often talk to students beginning their GCSEs in terms of their life clock. The idea that they should imagine their lifespan as a clock face, with these few years between the ages of 11 and 16, a narrow wedge on the clock. But that narrow wedge has a vast influence over what happens to them for the rest of the time on their life clock. The effort they put in, the attitudes, their values and ambitions for themselves will shape what is to come, affecting everything from what they do for a living, through to where they might live, the choices they have before them, the possessions they might have, their health, and even their lifespan. So whilst we place, quite rightly, a heavy emphasis on developing our students as confident individuals and citizens, we also understand the importance of results impacting on life chances. You can rest assured, therefore, that with the support of the college academic team and the wider trust, your children will receive the best possible chance of succeeding in their examinations and then moving on to the next step of their choice. Most importantly, however, great results mean that our students have choices. They can decide what step to take next as they've worked hard for that opportunity. Back in April 2019, I experienced Huon's College for the first time, just like many of you have in the past, as current parents or as visitors. If I'm honest, I was intrigued by the age of some of the buildings. I left school in 1985, and at moments I felt like I had slipped back in time. However, it's important to understand two things. Firstly, whilst the college site might not be winning any beauty pageants anytime soon, when I first visited, I was blown away not by state-of-the-art buildings or fancy furniture, but by the heart, soul, and potential of this wonderful learning community. Never judge a book by its cover. Secondly, the Rosedale Huon's Academy Trust is rolling out an extensive programme of refurbishment and rebuilding that will have a huge impact on the experience of future students, including an all-new performing arts space, a sprung dance floor, upgraded science labs, and a spectacular new learning resource centre. The second issue that confronts some parents when looking at Huon's College is our Ofsted inspection from March 2019. Historically, Huon's has always been graded as a good school, so this judgment of requires improvement was most unwelcome. However, it has clearly highlighted the areas in which the college needed to improve and has improved since that Ofsted inspection. And also in that inspection report, there were many positive reflections from the inspection team, some of which you can see here now on the slide I'm showing you, and in the college reception. Again, I would urge you to consider two things. Firstly, judge us from what you see and hear during this virtual event. And secondly, think about this. Would you rather your child belong to a dynamic, energetic learning community determined to show the world what it can do, or one that is drifting along on its long-gained laurels? And this brings me back to the sense of wonder that I mentioned at the start. I hope I've demonstrated to you how the decision to bring your child into the Huon's family would be one that would open doorways for them for a myriad of wonderful futures, to allow them to follow a path where they will discover talents that they never knew they had, and ultimately for them to leave us in 5 or 7 years' time as happy, confident, creative, and optimistic individuals with one eye on the future and the ability to make a positive difference to the incredible world that awaits them. Please take this opportunity to view all of the wonderful presentations and videos that our staff have prepared for you. And above all else, please do contact us via the college website and email and ask as many questions as you like. You will find that everyone in this college, from the teachers, to the site staff, to the teaching assistants, to the students, are all on one mission: to change the world. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. This is our food technology room. I'm going to take you through and show you what some students are cooking. Come on, let's go.
Ice and sugar, so I can make a nice pattern for a cake that I'm trying to design.
Okay, so today I will present to you these designs that you can use for cakes that we have made out of simple sugar paper. So we have this one here, and then you can also use the ending of this to make these two designs here. And then you can use sticks to make a nice little simple cross effect, and a knife and fork, metal or plastic. And you can also add some icing sugar to make some good effects, and a simple brush to get the effect.
Well, today I've been using some chocolate syrup and practicing my plating up so I can practice on cakes later. And I've also been using this gold dust, and I've just been simple placing it in the chocolate sauce. This has helped me a lot because then I know what I'm going to be doing on cakes and I don't mess up the cakes. I've also been using these like metal tiny balls just to in between the lines of the chocolate. And I've also used some chocolate powder that I can just simply put on with from this, and I just do that. I not only love food tech because it is an art form and a creativity, it gives me my opportunity to show my decorating skills and my art form.
Finer products of what I've done. This is a chocolate cake with chocolate syrup and cocoa powder. I achieved making this one after practicing just a minute ago.
So what we've been doing today is that we've been looking at different types of techniques to make these boring cakes look more attractive.
So today I've made a Swiss roll with Belgian chocolate, and a simple style but effective. So now I'm going to achieve my cake design.
Over here it has some nice chocolate sauce. I've made a little design here, so it comes out, which has glitter inside of it. Then I have some chocolate flakes around the cake, and then I have some vanilla icing on top of it with a chocolate ball on top. Same for this one as well.
So this is my end result, and it consists of some chocolate sauce with some chocolate flakes. As just a bit of design, and I put a bit of gold, like kind of dust, on my cake just for a little shine.
I put some strawberry syrup on the sides and then moved it with the spoon. Then I put some chocolate in a crisscross like that on the chocolate syrup to decorate it and make it look fancy.
So Huens also has GCC food technology, and in there I'm going to bring out their skills and give them skills they're going to need for the rest of their lives, as well as having lots of fun and being creative, like what we've got behind me. Thank you very much for joining us in Food Technology. We very much look forward to seeing you in September.
Welcome to our ICT block.
This is where we learn new technology using their computers.
Welcome to our ICT classroom. Join us while we do coding.
Can you tell me what you're coding?
I'm coding different faces.
What are you working on?
I'm coding my name.
Hello, why do you enjoy coding?
Hi, coding is very fun and I can do anything I want to. You too can do coding when you join Huens College.
Hello, can you tell our viewers what you're doing?
I'm just repairing this Lego robot.
Cool.
In our IT lessons, as you can see, we have robot opportunities where we build robots using Lego and then enter competitions nationally. We also have opportunities to code using our BBC microbits, and we fit those to the computer where the students are using programming languages such as Python. All of these things are available if you come and join us at Huens College.
Hi, I'm a Year 7 student and this is our field that I'm walking you to. The other day, I played rounders here and I really enjoyed it. And we play various sports here, like football and rounders.
And I'm in Year 9 at Huens College. I like PE at Huens College because I get to participate in the Young Sports Leaders, which includes me helping and teaching the younger years PE. I also like that there is a variety of sports such as softball and rounders.
And why did you choose to study GCSE PE at Huens College?
I chose to study GCSE PE because I want to be just like my idol Usain Bolt and have a mindset just like him. But for that to happen, I have to study GCSE PE and and study subjects such as psychology and diets.
I'm in Year 9.
That's PE at Huens College.
Before coming to Huens, I never knew I was good at PE. And after coming to Huens, I just discovered I was actually good at it, so I enjoyed it.
Okay, why did you choose to study GCSE PE?
I choose to study GCSE PE because it leads to my career pathway. And to get there, I need to understand sport. I need to be good at sport. I need to understand different subjects like criminal psychology.
Hello, welcome to our French cafe.
Salut Zara.
Salut Orphanie.
Tu as faim?
Oui, j'ai faim.
D'accord, on va manger.
Bonjour.
Bonjour monsieur.
Vous désirez quelque chose à boire?
Oui, des boules de raisin, un coca s'il vous plaît.
Et pour moi, je voudrais un jus d'orange.
Et pour manger?
Un sandwich au fromage et une glace à vanille s'il vous plaît.
Pour moi, une pizza et une glace au chocolat.
C'est tout?
Oui, merci. Ça fait combien?
25 euros.
Bonjour. Où est le restaurant, s'il vous plaît?
Vous allez tout droit. Pouvez-vous tourner à gauche?
Au revoir, on va te doigts, puis on tourne à gauche.
C'est bien, c'est jeune homme.
Merci beaucoup.
This is our dance studio. This is where we have our dance lessons and practice for performances.
Yourself with movement. You can be energetic, you can be all sorts of emotions, and you can get out so many things just by dancing.
I'm excited to do dance here at Humans, and it's I really like the teacher, and I really like the things that like we learn in dancing, and yeah, I really like it so much.
I really like to dance, and this dance is one of my dreams, and I love doing dance in Humans College, so this is my dream. Every day when you have dance lesson, I'm going back by smiling and excitement, and my parents are so happy because I'm excited. And I'm saying that is because I have dance and I love dance forever, and I want to be a professional dancer.
Dance is my favourite subject here at Humans College. It's so fun because we get to do loads of performances and we get to perform like big shows, and especially in this dance studio, because we are a wonderful teacher. She teaches us loads and loads of routines and teaches us loads of different ways on how to dance.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Bryden. I am the Associate Director of Performing Arts here at Humans College. I'm super excited about our performing arts curriculum that we have on offer for all of our students. At Key Stage 3, we teach every student dance and drama and music and art. It's a really exciting time for us here at the minute. We also offer BTEC for some of our older students in performing arts. In dance, students get to do all different dance styles, African dance styles, South Asian dance styles, hip-hop, contemporary, and they get taught technique, and we have coming up lots of fun clubs that they can join. We're really excited to be able to offer students an opportunity to come and share their vision and our vision of performing arts and expressing themselves. So if you are a parent or a carer or a student who loves performing arts, who loves singing, dancing, acting, musical theatre, expressing yourself, or just being creative, then definitely this is the school for you. Hope to see you soon.
We love dance at Humans! Woo!
This is the art block, and this is where our students do the art and design.
Hello, over here I'm drawing a rainbow for All Lives Matter.
I'm basically doing a poster about the NHS and All Lives Matter.
I love art because it's like a world where you can draw things and nobody can interrupt. Art is really fun. It's basically a world of colour.
Now walking to English, and here we have a murder scene.
We are here today at Bellstone Manor, where 50-year-old Mr. Douglas has been found murdered.
A gunshot was heard by our Mr. Barker at approximately 11:30 p.m. We came running downstairs to Mr. Douglas' study to find him shot and lying on the floor.
Mr. Douglas' housekeeper, Mrs. Allen, also heard a loud noise and came downstairs to see that her employer had been shot and stopped Mrs. Douglas from entering the room to see her deceased husband on the floor.
Mrs. Douglas did not seem to display any emotion such as shock or distress and was calmly led away whilst the butler, Ames, lit the lamp and called the police.
The police called upon me, Sherlock Holmes, as they were unable to piece the clues together and determine what happened at Bellstone Manor.
They wanted both I and Sherlock help them crack this case.
Of course they needed my dear Watson and I here with our detective expertise. So here we have multiple clues laid around this crime scene around Mr. Douglas.
You can see there is a double-barrel shotgun next to his blown-off face.
You can also see a hammer laying next to his arm.
There is a lamp on the table.
There's also a dumbbell laid underneath the lamp on the table.
You can see next to his dead body there is a half-lit candle.
And there is also a footprint leading outside of this window.
Last of all, there is a mysterious cult emblem on his body.
The only way you will find out the answers to this mystery is when you join Hewins College in September.
Enjoy these African rhythms from Senegal. We get to play a variety of instruments, for example, keyboards and drums.
Hello, welcome to our math department where all of the calculations are made. Personally, I really like to do bars and charts. I like to do it because it's interesting writing all the calculations onto it.
Welcome to Hewins Shopping Centre. We have Hewins Bank, Hewins Body Shop and H&C. We focus on calculating percentages in the real life. I've got an activity pack each
for you to do.
Welcome.
Hello, today I would like to put £60 on my account. Here's my credit card. And here's £60.
Hi, what would you like to
pay? How much are the creams?
The creams are £16, however, we are offering 25% off.
Wow, how much are
the rocks? The rocks are also £16.
Cool.
And can help us in our future and help us improve our problem-solving skills. We have My Maths from school that we can use at home to help us with our homework or anything that we're stuck on. Gateway to My Maths. In this video, you will learn how to monitor, know, and access your child's homework on My Maths. To log into My Maths, click the top right corner of the website and enter your school username and school password. Your school will provide you with a school username and a school password. For Hewins, it's Rosedale Equation. Your teacher will then provide you with your own personal username and password. Use this to log into your personal account to access all your homework. There, you'll be able to see any homework that your teacher has set you. You can click on the lesson if you need some help before or go straight to do the homework. There are two parts to the homework, part one and part two. Once you have finished answering all the questions, click mark it and you will be marked. Any wrong answers will be written in grey underneath. Do not worry if you get any wrong. The questions that you got correct will be put with a green tick by them, and the questions that you got wrong will have grey underneath them. Then complete part two. Once you're complete, click mark it. After you're finished, you can see your summary. Here you'll be able to see what you got for question one and what you got for question two and your overall percentage. If you want to try again, click the try again button or click finish and close. Then your homework will be complete. This is an example of a child that has not been doing their homework. As you can see, overdue will be in the top right corner. If your child's homework is overdue, they can still complete it by clicking the online homework button. If you want to check if your child's homework is overdone, just ask them for their login and password. You can log in via computer or phone, it doesn't matter. Thank you for visiting the Hewins College Gateway to My Maths. If you have any questions, ask any of the teachers in the maths department. Thank you.
So this is our science lab where we do all our experiments.
Hello, today we're going to be looking at cells under a microscope.
This experiment is called Flaming Hands. We put the gas into the bubble mixture. We make bubbles. We take the bubbles and we set fire to the bubbles and we make combustion.
A fantastic experiment, but make sure you don't do that at home.
At Huens, students love science, and we're looking forward to see you next year.
We hope you enjoyed our virtual tour. We look forward to seeing you in September.